In this video, we are going to create an expert advisor to trade this oscillator here. This is the stochastic oscillator. So let's find out how to do that with MQL5. To get started, please click on a little button here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the MetaEditor window, and here you want to click on File, New File, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file Simple Stochastic EA, click on Continue, Continue and Finish. Now you can delete everything above the onTick function and the two command lines here. We start with an include statement for the file trade.mqh. This one comes with MQL5 and we will use it to open buy or sell positions. Therefore, we start by creating an instance of the class ctrade that will do that for us. We will call it trade. Inside of the onTick function, we start by creating a string variable called signal. We don't assign a value here, that is going to be calculated later on. As we are going to trade in both directions, we need the ask price and the bid price. We can calculate both with the function SymbolInfoDouble. For the current symbol on the chart, we use Symbol_ask all in capital letters to get the ask price. And with normalized double and underscore digits, we automatically can calculate if the currency pair has 5 or 3 digits behind the dot. To get the bid price, we do the same, but this time we use Symbol_bid. Once that is finished, we create two arrays. One is the K array, the other one is the D array. Because the stochastic oscillator has two lines here, we need two arrays. We use ArraySetAsSeries for both arrays to sort them from the current candle downwards. And with the integrated function iStochastic, we can create our definition for the expert advisor. The first parameter is for the current currency pair on the chart. The second one is for the selected period on that chart. And these three values here also show up here in the oscillator. When we click on Properties, we will see that the default value for the K period is 5, the value for slowing is 3, and the D period is also 3. So that's what we use here. The last two parameters, mode_SMA and STO_low_high, stand for the simple moving average method and for the price field. So let's continue to fill the arrays. That is done by using copy buffer. According to the stochastic definition we have created here, for the K array we use buffer 0 and for the D array buffer 1. And we copy the values from candle 0 to candle 3 and store it in the K array or the D array. Now we can get the current value for the K array by looking into the K array, especially at the value in candle 0. To get the D value for the current candle, we do the same for the D array. And to get the values for the candle before, we do the same for candle 1. So now we know the current and the last values for both arrays. And we would have a buy signal if both values are below 20. That's the dotted line here. And if K value 0 is below 20 and D value 0 is below 20, we will check our next condition, and that is, we want to know if the current K value 0 is bigger than the D value 0. And if the last K value was below the D value, we have a crossover, and if that is the case, we assign the word buy to our signal. Otherwise, if the current K value and the current D value are bigger than 80, and that is the case when the two lines are above the upper dotted line here, that's when we check if the current K value is below the current D value. And if K value 1 was above D value 1 for the candle before, we have a sell signal. So now we assign the word sell to our signal. Now if our signal equals sell, and if the return value for positions total is below 1, or in other words, we don't have any open position, we use trade.sell to sell 10 micro lot. Otherwise, if the signal equals buy and we have no open positions, we use trade.buy to buy 10 micro lot. Finally, we use the comment statement to output the text the current signal is and the calculated signal directly on our chart. That's about it. If you don't know what all the code here does, or if this was too fast for you, you probably want to watch one of the other videos in this basic series first. Or maybe you are even interested to buy the premium course, you can find that one on our website. For now, let's click on the compile button or press F7. We don't have any errors here, and if that is the case, we can click on the little button here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader, we click on View, Strategy Tester, or press Ctrl and R. Please pick the new file simple stochastic.ea.ex5, mark the option for the visual mode here, and start a test. Here is our expert advisor, it is running, and we had a crossover right now. So now we should see the first trade on our chart. The expert advisor is working like expected. And in this little video, you have learned how to create an expert advisor for the stochastic oscillator, and you have coded it yourself with just a few lines of MQL5 code.